everybody. This sponsored Saturday is brought to you by Audible. So you can go to audible.com/gb or text gb to 500-500 to start your 30-day free membership trial. You get a free audiobook of your choosing and two free Audible originals. So if you don't know what Audible is yet, you may have guessed, it is a place to get your audiobooks. There is an insane number on there. Every single book that I've looked up has been on there, which is really fun. The latest one actually is a graphic novel called Nimona, and it's by Noelle Stevenson. It is the cutest story. It's very well written, and the voice acting is awesome. It was so fun to be able to listen to it. It was like listening to a TV show, seriously. And it's about these two little villains. It's a villain and his, she sort of forced herself upon him, as his sidekick, I suppose. And, I would definitely give it a listen if you're interested at all in that sort of style of storytelling. But once again, if you would like to check it out, you get one free audiobook a month and two free Audible originals, which means they're exclusive to Audible. Every single month, your credits roll over, and if you don't like your book, you can exchange it. So it's a really awesome program, and I hope you enjoy it. You can go follow the link in my description box to go to audible.com/gb, or you can text gb to 500-500. Thank you so much, Audible, and I hope you enjoy the video. Hello there. Welcome to GB's Trigger Test. Triggers don't have to be items. I think if you watched ASMR, you can know that it can simply be whispering, talking, no talking, just hand movements. And there are hundreds, if not thousands, of ways to trigger someone's relaxation or trigger their ASMR. But today, I wanted to go through a box. I organize all of my props and items that I use in these sort of stackable bins. And so while I was thinking about which ones I wanted to use, I opened the drawer and I was like, let's just go through my box. So if you like this video, we can go through another box another day or something like that. So it's very hard to organize seemingly random items. So what I did, all in here. We have our fabrics and sponges. We have our more, this one doesn't belong in there, popular triggers. So we have the toaster coaster in here, the regular coasters, earmuffs to salt and pepper shakers. And then we have some jars, mini cups, a little egg shaker. Oh, I fit the little light from the dollar store video. And we have the tattoo gun, but tattoo gun aka electric toothbrush, but I think we're gonna leave that one out for the day. And we have our little notebook that I'll be writing down your ratings for each trigger. So what I would like to do is, would you mind telling me your name? It's a very unique name. Never met anyone with that name. Never. No, you're the first one. Okay, so how do you feel about starting with the fabric sounds? You feel very positively about. Well, that's just wonderful to hear. Thank you so much. I have quite a few bits of fabric in here. Shall we start with the fluff? Very good. You seem like a person who can appreciate a good fluff. Now this is just a rectangle of fur. albeit shedding a little bit. And I just want you to imagine what this might feel like if you were to touch it. May I touch it to your face? Very soft. Okay. On the back, there is the rougher side. So this really could double as a 2-for-1 trigger. To roll it up and put it back in the box. And the next piece of fabric is our faux snakeskin, which I believe survived since before my childhood. So this is actually probably from around 1994. Obviously a very high quality piece of scrap fabric. I do believe this came from an Aladdin costume, not Disney's Aladdin. My mother could correct me if I'm wrong. It was a very quaint is soft. You don't have to use a lot of force for it to sound nice. I'm very, very gently brushing my fingers over it. Would you say that you prefer this to the fluffy fabric? I do have a few more to show you, but I must say this one is one of our best. Next piece of fabric, I believe is, I want to say this is pure cotton. This is a piece of cloth from Japan. that I got on my trip there. And to be quite fair with you, I'm not sure what I would use this for. It has the same... It looks like something like a towel you would put in your kitchen. But I'm afraid to stain it. So now it lives in my box of fabric triggers. It has tiny little sailboats on it. Clouds. Now this one's going to be a softer sound. That's fine. You can't just quite say that fabric sounds are your favorite, because then it's the question of which fabric. But we'll roll this up into a little microfiber cloth. This is a cleaning cloth. Do you mind if I clean your eyes? Wow, lovely, lovely, lovely. Your vision must be very clear. Cloth isn't my favorite in terms of how it feels, though. But I think the sound makes up for it. Very nice, scratchy sound. Now this one is going to be a little bit tricky to get a sound out of. We might have to keep it rolled up. Might not be able to tell from this lighting, but it is bright pink. Very smooth. Stretch fabric. When it's all rolled up like this, it makes a very lovely sound. You can't really scratch it. It makes sort of wrinkles. I think this is more suited towards smooth sounds. It's like a big piece of taffy or something. Forbidden food. Our last true piece of fabric is this probably polyester golden fabric. It's making a wonderful squishing. Videos before, but it reminds me when, like, in anime when they squeeze their fist. Not the sandy sound, the squeaky sound. Remember what costume I used this for? Azula. And I want to say Farah. Whoever used this fabric for. But I think this is what I used to cover some of the gold bits for my Azula costume. I'm working on a Zuko one right now. The other side is like a, well, it's gold, but it's like a dull brownish gold. Some people don't like that sound, so I'll stop. Let me roll this up. This one definitely would compete for my favorite, I think. Do I keep that? Sometimes it's so hard to roll something straight. Mostly because this was in my fabrics pile, so we're gonna count it. It's these little square spongies from the dollar store. This probably very much mimics like touching. I have my light set to yellow right now, so they might look a little weird, but I promise you, that's the colors. I regret the best. Mad in board games. These would always be the colors. Red, green, yellow, or blue. And I always wanted there to be purple or black. Because everyone knows out of these four colors, red and blue are the coolest. And then, are you stuck with green? Are you stuck with yellow? I'm about to make some fighting friends, I think. Red flavored everything too. Red popsicles, red lollipops, red starbursts, although I think pink are probably my favorite. They're probably tied. Red Skittles, red Jolly Ranchers, red Laffy Taffy. I'm making myself want candy now. We have these scratchy sponge. We have our gold polyester. Our pink. This actually might be orange. I think this is too. Oh, this is to my mercy. Cosplay my mercy sleeve. I don't know why I thought that was pink. Soft fabric there. Microfiber cloth. Our cotton dishcloth. So you should probably rank them and let me know. Should I pick my own favorite? I think the snake skin is my favorite. The snake skin, followed closely behind by the gold polyester. Then the scratchy sponges. The orange soft fabric, then the fur, then I think the cotton dishcloth, and last the microfiber cloth, because I don't like touching it, but to be honest, I think these all sound really nice. I'm a little bit biased on what feels good to touch. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So that was 7 fabric tests. Let's move on to the next mini bin. Here we have mini solo cups and a shaker egg, which I will get out. Our kitty jar. Plastic jar. Light switch. Nightlight, plastic credit card. This is usually just for a whole place. These cards. I'm going to show you these first. Little ribbon. And our fidget spinner. I was never really a fan of the fidget cube for ASMR. I definitely enjoy using it. I would bring it to class senior year of college. Mostly I would just type on my computer. If you don't know what a fidget cube is, each side is tactical in its own way. And it's supposed to help with restless hands, and restless brain. I really like the smooth side. It's just a little indentation. These buttons all have different feels to them. Now, of course, I don't want to put it down. I think this blue button. I was surprised to really enjoy the present ribbon. This is from the dollar store. I feel like my lights are dimming.
Is it just me?
I'm gonna check. I think they're all... Nope, they're at 100%. Okay, it's just me. Stick it on your head. Beautiful. Okay, these cards. Did I show them to you yet? River. The family member I cosplayed with made these. Can you tell what they are? It's an entire deck of cards, but with Smash characters. So you have Bowser, Falco. I'm about to be tested. Game and Watch, Fox, Jigglypuff, Ness. No, I really, my whole family, cousins, everybody played so much Super Smash growing up. I really don't like the game, so forgive me if I don't. Link, Robin. Kirby, yes, my main. Everyone's main if you had an older brother. Diddy Kong. Diddy Kong is a joker. Peach. That's the queen. King Dedede. Oh, Olimar. Pikmin guy. That's the ace. And then it goes around again. I think they're different colors. Are they? Yeah, they are. So, like, see the two Falco, red, blue, seven, purple. But how cute is that? She's awesome. We cosplayed Peach and Bowser together, so she gave me this for Christmas. And I adore them. I should probably use them for real, but they're so, like, special. So that was a little show and tell trigger. I always like when people go through collections. Bank. It is a play credit card, so I can give you the numbers to it. 5617296 1. issue date is 0603. So they made the sticker back in 2003. I think this is like a seashell. But then how it cuts off here makes it look like a cake or a donut. But I'm pretty sure it's a seashell. You know I'm a fan of tapping. We have our nightlight. It's a bit of a visual trigger as well. You could give this to your Valentine. With like a Sharpie or something on the front. Right. You turn me on. It's a dollar at the dollar store. You're welcome. Or if you don't want to be as crass, you could say, "You light up my life." That's a little better, huh? Jars, containers. One of my favorite older videos. Why does that smell weird? One of my favorite older ASMR videos was Maria Gentle Whisperings tea tasting ceremony. And in the end, I think I watched that video 100 times, I swear. In the end, she pulls out the next year's tea, and they're in these little glass jars that sort of sit on their side like this, so it's like flat here, and they fit together. She opens each one. I'm not sure if she opens each one, but I think you get to pick one to open. I think I want to revisit that. Tea tasting ceremony by Gentle Whispering. Tell her Gibi sent you. I bet you could find like my old comments there. I never commented a lot. I obviously had a YouTube that wasn't Gibi ASMR. So now that I like have this channel, some of like the people that I used to love watching, like, I'm not subscribed to them on this channel, I'm subscribed to them on my like other old channel. So I always have to go back and see if this channel is sub to them. Let me show you the other one though. I don't know how I feel about glass. You tell me. about this jar is the lid. Jar, plastic jar. I can't decide because I like how this sounds better than this, but I like this better than this. Oh, we also have. I'm really torn. I cannot choose. We have our mini red solo cup. Makes the same sort of sound as a lid sound. With moving parts, I'll give you a lot of sounds. It might be my favorite so far. Our final one for this little box. after that for too long. Mini box number two. We have the egg shaker, the mini solo cups, the kitty jar, the plastic jar, the deck of cards, the light, the fidget spinner, cube, and the credit card. My order for box number two, I think the solo cups are my favorite. And I really like the cards. I think I'm gonna go with the kitty jar, and then immediately after the plastic jar, the light, the credit card, the fidget spinner, no, the egg, and then the fidget cube. Let me know what you think. Let's move on to box number three. Our final box has some of my favorite items of all time in it. These little keys. Yeah, not those. We have the salt and pepper shaker. This is the broken one. I'll just use the broken one today. The little lamp reading light. Earmuffs. Coaster. And Scratchy Sponge. Crunchy Sponge Part 2. Okay. These are objects that I use quite a bit in my videos. I'm going to start with the earmuffs because these are the ones that I'm not quite sure what to do with. These unfold and you can put them on the ears of the 3DO, the ship. I'll just scratch my ears, I suppose. So I got these before I found my super fluffy earmuffs at a Target. And while these totally work, they're not my favorite earmuffs. This is very loud to me. I'm not sure how much you can hear it, but it's very loud to me. I do really like about them, though, are the little collapsing mechanism in the top. It feels very satisfying. Almost like cracking your fingers or your neck. Or your toes. Spring has sprung, and I don't really need headphones anymore. Headphones. I'll always need headphones. Earmuffs anymore. They fold, so they're very good for traveling. Pockets. But I definitely don't pull these out too often to make videos. Don't hate them. Now we have our light. I really like this one because it reminds me of the light that Allie uses in the departure series when she's taking your brain scan. So yeah, because she holds this part so delicately. And you flip the light on. Light triggers are very effective. It's a plus that this is ridged. I don't really use it that much as a sound trigger. I just like that it's got a very easy switch in the back that makes a sound, but it's not too loud. Could clamp onto something. This is like a reading light for your bed. It's really not that bright. It's got four little tactile buttony things on the back. We're just here too. This would probably be my favorite trigger for somebody else to use on me, like in a video. Just saying. Now we have our four beautiful MVPs. Now this is our newest one. So I haven't used it much, actually. You know what's in a different box? The emo belt. That's in the emo box. Ridges on the bottom here. That doesn't slide so much on the table. I'll move then to our oldest trigger. I think They might have actually appeared in the same video, but I think I used this coaster before the toaster coaster. Don't quote me on that. It sounds different with really long nails. Our scratchy sponge that I bought for a Lorelei video and just kept around because I liked it so much. I'm doing almost no pressure on the sponge at all, just like the back is soft. It's microfiber cloth, but I don't mind touching it. It's a very squishy sponge. What I like about it is that you can squish it. The other side. A bit soft. But mostly I just like to scratch it. Our beloved toaster coaster. It's one of my absolute favorite sounds, and it actually always has been, even before I discovered ASMR. I always loved cork objects. I thought they were so satisfying. To me, it's just like a softer wood, and I think wood is really satisfying as well. since Sponge and Wood had a baby. Really like fast tapping. And I think it sounds really good on the court because it's so spongy. But you still get like that solid tap. I need a scratch too. Okay, are you ready? Toaster, roaster, sponge, regular coaster, salt shaker, light, and earmuffs. Let's rank them. For me, my favorite will always be the toaster coaster. Then I gotta put the light. I love that light. Scratchy sponge. Salt shaker. Regular coasters. And I think the last thing is the earbuds. So now you have to decide which box you like the best. Whether it was box one, which was the snakeskin called polyester, scratchy spongies, the orange soft fabric, the cotton fabric, the fur, and the microfiber. Box number two, which were the solo cups, the cards, the kitty jar, the plastic jar, the light, on and off one, credit card, shaky egg, and fidget cube. Or box three, which is the toaster coaster, the light, the scratchy sponge, salt shaker, regular coaster, and earmuffs. So, if you did make it through this entire video, I would be blessed if you actually would let me know, because I'm curious. So, I hope you enjoyed this trigger test. I hope that it helped you realize what triggers you might like going forward, but I hope that it was an enjoyable experience in itself. So, thank you so much for watching, as always, and I'll see you in the next video.